How does a conservative pick a country that they want to pick for a second passport and citizenship? I'm going to give you some actual details on what you should be looking for if you're going to be looking for a second passport. And if you're a conservative, these are the type of things that you need to look for. Also, if you are interested in getting your income taxes to zero, how to get a second passport as quick as 3 months, do three things. Hit the subscribe button on the right of your screen here and you'll get new videos as they come out automatically. And number two is I'd like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, just put it below and I'll be glad to get with you. And number three is go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com, and ask for some help and be glad to help you out. Okay, now, what you should be looking for is countries that allow dual citizenship, and you also need to be looking for countries that are pure tax havens or either territorial countries, and you want countries that are not going to make you relinquish your other citizenship. I would also stay away from all EU countries. I've mentioned this on several occasions, these golden visa programs. They're basically tax traps to get you in there for a little bit more visa-free travel. And most of those visa-free travel countries is not really making that much difference. You can get a top-notch fast-track program like St. Kitts and Nevis, and you can have just about as good a visa-free travel. And the difference in those countries are not that much difference. And you get around paying high income taxes. I've also mentioned EU countries are more than likely going to start hitting you with wealth taxes in the future, and also taxing based on citizenship. If you really want to be real conservative in what you're doing, I would be checking with these countries that I'm going to be listing here, and stick with these type countries. I kind of did a sort in my mind of the best ones I thought that allow dual citizenship. Most of these two, you can speak English language. There are a few here that have foreign language requirements, but they do allow dual citizenship. Most of them are very inexpensive to live. Most of them are have visa-free to the Schengen countries, and they're good picks if you want to pick from these. Another thing I would tell you to do too is go to countries that don't have a dictator. You want countries that are where you know they have public elections where people can be voted in office. I lived in Dubai for 5 years. It's not a free country. You hear a lot of people talk about, you know, the tax status and everything, and they've never lived there, so they don't know what it's like. Dubai is not a free country. I think it's getting that way. It's getting better. They're making some changes and so forth. But it's you definitely are not going to be having a free country if you move to Dubai. The visa-free travel is good there. And now they're opening up to where they'll allow dual citizenship. But the people that are going to get those dual citizenship passports are going to be very few in number. And I think most of these people are going to find out they're going to have to wait the statutory time period of 30 years. That's one reason I left Dubai off my list. If they would make some changes, it would be a top-notch country if they did away with those issues and made a predictable time period of maybe 5 years at least, you know, where you could apply and it's a predictable time period to where you can get the passport and citizenship. This is the problem that you have with the UAE, but it's coming along, and I think it's going to be over the next 10, 15 years, I think possibly it will become more free a country that you can go to and feel good about living there. But we'll see what happens there. Also, I would be looking for countries that have, like I said, a dual citizenship. It can be, countries that have the fast track or slow track programs. It doesn't have to be the citizenship by investment, but you need to make sure they have dual citizenship. What you're going to find out is a lot of the countries in Central America have really good territorial tax systems, but they don't allow dual citizenship on some of them. Belize allows it. Honduras does in some instances, but very limited. These are things that you have to look at. El Salvador is pretty nice as far as they do allow dual citizenship in some instances, but it does tax worldwide income for residents, so we left that off the list. But I'm going to list some of the countries here and tell you a little bit more about them and emphasize some things that I think that would be important for you. We did have St. Kitts and Nevis on the list. It actually had more visa-free countries on arrival for countries and territories than any of the countries on this list. And of course, it has a fast track and it has a slow track program too. One of the things I do want to tell you is the slow track program with St. Kitts and Nevis is probably the most untalked about residency program in the world today. There's nothing on the internet unless you pull up one of my old videos. There's just nothing to really promote it because it's not a big money maker for the country. But I'll tell you something, they're missing out by not promoting it because St. Kitts has one of the best residency by investment programs out there in the marketplace today. And I'll tell you why. It has dual citizenship. It allows no income tax, no capital gains tax, no estate tax, no inheritance tax, English speaking. But you almost have to, you don't have to put any investment at all, hardly in. It's just mostly fees. And it's incredible that most people don't know about this. So, you know, this is a program that's really a neat program that you can look at. The period to get before you can apply for citizenship on the residency is around 14 years. You probably won't get it in 14 years. I've dealt with people, and I'm going to have actually a person on that will actually talk on their residency by investment in St. Kitts, what they did, the money they spent for it, the time period. We're going to have that on another meeting. So if you stay tuned for that, because that's going to be real interesting talk there. Okay, let me give you some of the programs that I've got here that I think that if you're going to choose for residency by investment, these are top-notch countries that you need to look at in moving to, especially if your business can be done from anywhere in the world. The Cayman Islands, I like it a lot, and I'll tell you why. It's a pure tax haven. Not only does it have any income tax, it has no corporate income tax either. It's great weather all year round. They do have hurricanes, but it's very sporadic. Beautiful beaches. Some of the beaches are some of the nicest in the world. It is probably the most expensive place to live I've got on this list as far as food, clothes, and things like this. Education and healthcare is excellent. They've got top-notch doctors, probably some of the best in the whole Caribbean there. The second one, of course, is St. Kitts and Nevis. St. Kitts and Nevis is a pure tax haven. St. Kitts does have a corporate tax rate and a limited company rate of 33%, but everybody just avoids it. They get an unincorporated business. Right now, it's around 2%. But St. Kitts is a lot cheaper to live in than the Cayman Islands. This is one, you know, neat thing about it. And you can pick, like I said, if you can go there, you can go to St. Kitts and do the residency by investment. And if you get tired of waiting, you just switch it to the citizenship by investment. Very few countries have that where you can just switch like that. So, you know, it's, you know, you can start off one way and then go the other way if you want. But it is a real unique place to live, and it's a lot cheaper than the Cayman Islands, and it has a lot more visa-free travel too. The Caymans, you know, you're going to have to wait years before you can get the passport, and it's going to take a lot of money of investing to get that that residency that leads up to citizenship. So you have to have quite a bit of money to do that. Where St. Kitts, you don't have to have. In fact, if you go with the real estate option, the minimum is $200,000 with St. Kitts. But that's going to get you in a fractional unit. I've told you avoid fractional units. You ought to go with full service units or where you own the whole unit yourself. The minimum on that is $400,000 that you would have to invest. All right, now Antigua and Barbuda is another one that's a pure tax haven. It has not quite the visa-free travel that St. Kitts does, but it does have actually the second best, and I just did a video on that, of all the fast-track programs. It is more expensive to live. It's actually between the Cayman Islands and St. Kitts. It is more expensive to live there, food, clothes, drugs, and things like this. One of the most misunderstood countries that it just blows my mind that most people don't think about is Guatemala. Guatemala has actually almost a tax system that's almost a pure tax haven. It's incredible how low, not only the where you can not have to pay any income taxes outside the country, but the internal tax is almost zero. It's real low. And I've got videos on Guatemala. You can look at that too. Now, Guatemala is probably the cheapest country as far as things to buy, food, medicine. If you around the clock, nursing care, you know, at retirement, and there are places that are off the wall like this that are going to be the new fast-growing areas to go in, and this is where you can buy property really, really inexpensive if you're looking to do that. Ecuador is another one. I like Ecuador because, of course, all of these allow dual citizenship. None of these require you to relinquish your passport that you currently have. Ecuador is really nice because it's very inexpensive, like Guatemala. And of course, you do have to pass the Spanish test in Guatemala and also Ecuador to get the passport and citizenship. That's probably the biggest disadvantage there. The visa-free travel, of course, in Guatemala is better than Ecuador. Guatemala does have visa-free travel to the Schengen countries. St. Vincent and the Grenadines, I've got another tape I put out on that. That's a real good program. It has dual citizenship, has a territorial tax system. It's not a pure tax haven. It's a beautiful place to live in the Leeward Island chain of countries. And this is one place that you ought to consider, English speaking. I prefer staying in English speaking countries. I think also the values on real estate actually do better also. Another country is Belize. Belize does allow dual citizenship. The visa-free travel is not all that hot. You don't have visa-free to the Schengen countries, although I think that will be passed probably not too far down the road because all the Central American countries just about have visa-free travel to the Schengen countries except for Belize. There might be one other one in there. I'd have to sit down and study it, but I think that's probably about the only one there that does not have it now. But I think that's down the pipe, but it's an English speaking country, which is one thing I like, and it does allow dual citizenship. It's fairly inexpensive there. It's probably, you know, a little bit higher than Costa Rica, it is a neat place to live, very backcountry type place. And the last one here is one that you probably don't hear about a lot, and that's Dominican Republic, probably the cheapest country in the Caribbean. It's got a lot of things going for it. They changed the laws in 2007. They've got a territorial tax system now. And before that, they didn't have that, and they found out they could lure a lot of foreigners in by coming out with a territorial tax system. So you can live there, have income made outside the country, and not be taxed on that. So now the passport's not all that great. You don't have visa-free to the Schengen countries, but I think it's down the road. That will come soon. Probably when it comes in, there's going to be a lot harder to get it, and they'll probably... Because right now you don't have to pay that much, basically fees to get it, and you can get the passport in about, they say about 2 to 3 years. You won't get it in that length of time. Look at 5 to 6 years. No matter what anybody tells you, you won't get it there that quick. It always takes longer in places like that to get the. I'm talking about from the time you apply, the time you get the passport. Count on 5 to 6 years at least before you get that passport. You're supposed to pass or have at least some sort of Spanish. Fluency. It doesn't have to be real fluent, but you need to be able to speak a little bit of Spanish according to, and I've heard other people say that there are people that have gotten through that did not have to be fluent in Spanish. So I think it depends on the time that you actually apply for the passport. Anyway, if you're interested in learning more, if you will go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com, hit that top bar that says apply with us, fill out the questions, hit that bottom bar that says send it to us, and we'll get back with you, see what we can do to help you. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button on the right of your screen right here, and you get new videos as they come out automatically. And I would like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, just put it below. And we deal with a lot of citizenship and residency by investment, countries all over the world that I think you'd be interested in learning about. And I look forward to talking to you on the next video. Take care.